The first thing that we need to be sure of is that the bike is standing in an upright position. Prepare the bike by removing the seat and gas tank. Remove the clutch perch assembly from the bars. Now remove the rear master cylinder reservoir cap. Remove the bolts holding the master cylinder to the frame. Use the included syringe to remove excess brake fluid. If the brake fluid is dirty, dispose of it. Dirty brake fluid should never be reused. Insert one of the included rubber O-rings into the bottom of the stock master cylinder. Make absolutely sure that the O-ring is lying flat on the bottom of the rear master cylinder. Install the Rekluse adapter sleeve. Tighten the sleeve down firmly against the O-ring to create a seal. Use blue Loctite to attach the OEM rear master cylinder back to the frame. Now at this point, it is easiest to route your brake line. Before you actually run the brake line down through, make sure that you install the included heat shield to the brake line. This protects it from the exhaust heat. Start running the line by inserting the end with the banjo fitting already installed in behind the front number plate. Run the line along the left side of the frame stanchion and continue fitting the line down behind the motor, but in front of the rear shock. From this point, go ahead and push it through to the right side of the bike, where the rear master cylinder is located. To attach the hydraulic brake line, we need to go to the hardware that's supplied in the kit. Sandwich the banjo bolt between the square ring seals. Secure the banjo bolt to finger tight, keeping it loose enough to swivel until the system is fully installed. Use the included zip ties to anchor the brake line away from the exhaust pipe. This also keeps it away from the rear shock. The best way to do this is to secure it to the OEM rear brake line. Use other zip ties to tie the brake line to the OEM clutch cable or the hydraulic clutch line. Be sure to clip off the excess zip tie. Now we can go back up to the handlebars and mount the Rekluse master cylinder. Position the Rekluse master cylinder as close to where the final position will be as we need to cut the brake line to fit. Be sure that you give yourself enough slack to account for the turning of the handlebars. It's better to have a little extra slack than not enough. Cut the line straight using good scissors or cable cutters. Once the line is cut to length, add the boot, then the compression nut, then add the brass barbed fitting into the end of the line. Ensure that the barb is fully inserted into the line. Improper installation of the brass barbed fitting will prohibit the system from sealing when pressurized. Insert the assembled line into the Rekluse master cylinder and thread the nut in. Torque the compression fitting to 70 inch pounds. Don't forget to slide the boot over the nut when fully tightened down. At this point of the installation process, we can go ahead and bleed the brake system. Check your brake pads to make sure they have at least 50% life left and that they are in overall good condition. Rekluse recommends new brake pads for best performance. To begin this process, start by wrapping a shop towel or a paper towel underneath the rear brake caliper. Fill the included syringe with .3, .4, or .5.1 brake fluid. Do not use .5 or silicone-based fluid. Remove the dust cap on the rear bleed nipple and make sure there is no debris. Attach an 8mm end wrench to the bleeder bolt. Secure the syringe to the bleed nipple. Once connected, turn the syringe upright and tap it to remove the air bubbles. Now position the Rekluse master cylinder so that the bleed port is at the highest point of the system. Remove the T10 Torx bleed screw. Attach the supplied fitting where the bleed screw was removed from. Secure a suitable container to hold excess brake fluid. attach the rubber hose to the bleed fitting. Push the rear caliper inward toward the hub to bottom out the caliper piston. This will force brake fluid into the rear master cylinder. Overflow can happen. Now open the bleed nipple. Push fluid using the syringe until fluid starts coming out of the rear master cylinder sleeve. Tighten the banjo bolt back down on the rear master cylinder sleeve. Now we can push fluid up through the entire system. You will see fluid start to come out of the rubber overflow hose. Close the rear caliper bleed nipple. Check the adequate pressure has been achieved at the foot pedal. Now open the bleed nipple. Push fluid through until there are no air bubbles coming out of the line. Have another person help you at this point. As one person is rotating the master cylinder and tapping it, the other person should be pushing brake fluid out at the same time. If you see air bubbles continue to come out, keep repeating this back bleeding process until there are no more air bubbles. Close the rear caliper bleed nipple. Then we can remove the overflow line. If you pinch the line off right at the fitting, you will avoid any spillage. Unscrew the bleed fitting. Pump the lever to ensure adequate pressure has been achieved. You may need to pump the lever a few times to build pressure. If fluid can't be seen in the bleed port at this point, lightly push brake fluid until it barely starts to seep from the open port. It's best to use two people during this phase of the install. Reattach the T10 Torx screw. If the lever still feels spongy, repeat the back bleeding process. The Rekluse left-hand rear brake has an adjustable lever position. Use this to optimize your braking control. Remount the clutch perch assembly to the bars. If mounting below the clutch lever, ensure that the clutch lever has enough clearance so as not to hit the Rekluse master cylinder. If there's interference between these two, one or the other needs to reposition so this does not happen. So that concludes the installation of the left-hand rear brake kit from Rekluse. As with anything new, it takes time to adjust and train yourself. Be sure to become familiar with your setup before attempting a challenging ride.